from News 8 WMTW-TV, this is a News 8 NOW update.
Good evening and welcome back to News 8 NOW. I'm Megan Torgerson. Visiting hours for Krista Dittmeyer were today with a funeral set for tomorrow. Investigators found the 20-year-old's body Wednesday in the water at the Cranmore Mountain ski area in North Conway. Dittmeyer had been missing since April 23rd. Her 14-month-old daughter was found inside her abandoned car. Authorities say Dittmeyer's death is being investigated as suspicious and the cause and manner are still pending. A funeral is scheduled for tomorrow at 5 o'clock in Lake Region High School's gym in Naples. Three bills that would add new restrictions on abortion in Maine face legislative committee reviews this week. One of the bills would require a 24-hour waiting period prior to an abortion, except in the case of a medical emergency. Also, state health officials would have to develop a brochure educating women on abortion. A third bill seeks to repeal Maine's current adult consent law. It would require notarized written consent of a parent or legal guardian before an abortion may be performed on a minor, with a few exceptions. A rally in Augusta today to commemorate workers' rights and International Workers' Day. Folks who attended the gathering in Capitol Park say today's event is an effort to show the current administration that workers' rights are important here in Maine. Among the big issues discussed, fair wages and a safe work environment top the list.
It's important that all employees are treated with dignity, just as all businesses are treated with dignity. And it's coming together at the same table and making the negotiation for fair wages and good working conditions that makes this country strong.
The rally also highlighted the connection between workers and immigrants' rights. Ralliers called for immigration reform and the passage of the DREAM Act, a bill that would allow undocumented immigrants to receive citizenship through military service or higher education.
Never appeal to me.
A second grader from Pond Cove Elementary School organized this event at the local Buzz in Cape Elizabeth. After learning about Dr. Martin Luther King Jr., Truly Chilemi wanted to do something to help her community. She put this concert together, which is also a food drive called Food is Hope, to benefit Wayside Food Programs. The organization provides meals and nutrition education for needy families. Health officials say Lyme disease cases have increased over the last 5 years here in Maine and occur in all 16 counties. The bacterial infection, which is carried by the deer tick, is preventable. The best ways to prevent infection are to wear protective clothing, use insect repellent, perform daily tick checks, and use caution in tick habitats. The most common early symptom of Lyme disease is an expanding red rash. Lyme disease is treatable. It's the second most commonly reported disease in Maine, and May is Lyme Disease Awareness Month. Scientists have kicked off the first seal survey in a decade to determine how many there are now in New England. Scientists say indicators suggest the population has continued to grow in the past 10 years. Census got underway in April when seals were captured off Cape Cod and Maine. Thank you for joining us here on News 8 Now. I'm Megan Torgerson. Stay with us for the latest weather and sports highlights. We'll be right back.